Hi, I'm Julia, and I've always dreamed of becoming a model. I want to tell you the story of how I accidentally drove my mom to hysteria because of that dream. It all started when a new girl came to our class. During the very first lesson, Anna immediately became the center of attention. It was a gym class, and she tried to do a cartwheel but couldn't make her feet leave the floor. The girl was all sweaty and red but didn't give up. Our classmates were having a blast. She's a little pig, but she did it. Then, all of a sudden, with a loud ripping sound, Anna's pants burst at the seams. Everyone roared with laughter, but I felt sorry for her. I sat down, tore up my joggers, and said, "Actually, ripped clothes are trendy now. You don't know a damn thing about fashion." I was quite popular at school, so people listened to me. Our classmates stopped laughing, and Anna thanked me for saving her. We got to talking. She turned out to be a cool girl, but seemed quite unhappy for some reason. She had no friends at all. Her classmates had always laughed at her for her figure, and she had had to change 3 schools because of that already. I'm afraid the same thing will happen here. What if you threw a cool party? You'd make friends with everyone faster that way. Anna liked my idea and invited her classmates to her place that evening. At first, everything was going great. We were chilling by the pool and chatting about all sorts of nonsense. But then I suddenly saw Anna. She was sitting on a sunbed away from anyone, wrapped in a towel and doing something on her phone. Well, I decided that just wouldn't do. I came up to my new friend and dragged her to the bar by the hand. But then Whitney approached us, the meanest girl at school. She stepped on Anna's long towel and it fell to the ground. The new girl was left in a swimsuit. That's what she had been afraid of. Everyone was laughing again. I had to avenge my new friend. I grabbed Whitney by the hair and tried to throw her into the pool. But I accidentally hit Anna and she, waving her arms, plopped into the water. Oops. It turned out she couldn't swim. I threw her a swimming ring. I wish I'd come up with a better idea. Anna got stuck in it and floundered even more. All around, everyone was dying laughing. Somehow she reached the side of the pool and I helped her out of the water. Anna was very angry and said that the party was over. Who would have thought that the next morning everything would be even worse? It turned out that Whitney had taken a picture of me dragging Anna out of the pool with a tense face and sent those pictures to all the school group chats. In just one day, we became a walking meme. Anna completely withdrew into herself, but I still managed to get her to talk. My neighbor was at the party yesterday. I've liked him for a long time, but after such a disgrace, he will never look twice at me. Anyway, this party was a mistake. Now everyone is making fun of me even more. I was getting tired of her whining. I decided to rid my friend of her old insecurities. In fact, I knew just how to do it. Whenever I felt self-conscious about something, I put on my best clothes, rented a photo studio on the roof of a skyscraper, and took pictures of myself. After that, I would look at the pictures and realize I'd been stressing out in vain. The most important thing to do was to love yourself. If you did that, others would reach out to you themselves. That's what I decided to teach my chubby classmate. We went up to my favorite studio and I showed Anna one tricky pose. You need to put your foot back, half turn to the camera and tilt your head back a little. That will make you look much thinner in the photo. And of course, the look is important too. It has to be confident and proud. Anna turned out to be a good student. We made a bunch of cool photos. She couldn't stop looking at them and kept thanking me. To be honest, I was flattered. It turned out I was a talented model because I knew how to turn even someone so plain into a beauty. We started coming to the roof almost every day. After our lessons, Anna became more and more bold and beautiful. I liked the way she followed my every instruction. But the thing was, our hobby wasn't cheap. I didn't have enough pocket money to rent the studio and kept asking my mom for more and more. In the end, she began to suspect something. "Why do you need so much money?" "I'm taking extra physics classes." I was ashamed to admit to my mom that I was spending her money on such stuff. But one day, my lie was almost discovered. That day, the results of the physics test came in. One, I had failed. When I got home, mom was very angry. "Just what are we paying money for? Give me your tutor's number." My phone has died. I'll recharge it and give it to you." Mom went to the shower and looked through my contacts. Well, who was going to play the role of my tutor? Without thinking twice, I chose Kevin. Mom definitely didn't know him because we'd met a couple of days ago in the photo studio. He worked there as a photographer. I quickly dialed Kevin and convinced him to play along. Everything went great. Kevin promised my mom he would deal with my bad mark. She calmed down a little and gave me money again. So the next morning, I went to school in a great mood. But then I suddenly saw Kevin. "Julie, a favor for a favor. I'm putting together a portfolio to get a job in a glossy magazine. And I'm looking for a beautiful model for a shoot in a swimsuit. Will you help me?" "Me? But in a swimsuit? It's a bit too much." "Don't worry, those photos won't go anywhere. I'll just show them at the job interview and that's it." I hesitated for a long time, but in the end, Kevin managed to convince me. We agreed to meet at the photo studio after classes. I came to school and Anna suddenly bumped into me in the corridor. She was crying. Why did you lie to me? I believed in myself, posted those photos on Instagram and waited for likes, but there's only hate in the comments. All of our classmates are laughing at me. They say it's all Photoshop. I was about to calm my friend down, but Whitney appeared next to me again. Who were you trying to deceive? Like we haven't seen you in real life? Whitney, that's enough. The photos weren't edited. It's just beautiful makeup and a good pose and angle. I stood up for Anna, as best I could, but I lost the war. Soon, the other students joined Whitney, and my excuses simply weren't enough for the whole crowd. Anna ran away from school. I spent the whole day trying to reach her, but she didn't even read my messages. I wanted to go to her after classes, but then I remembered my promise to Kevin. I was in no mood to pose and smile, but I still went home to get a swimsuit and came to the studio. At first, I felt terribly embarrassed. Kevin asked me to look at the camera and stand in immodest poses while he ran around and took pictures. After a couple of hours, I wasn't feeling shy at all, and even suggested an idea for a photo. They should be enough. Thank you, Julie. You're awesome. As soon as I edit them, I'll send you all the photos. I was so happy that I completely forgot about my friend's problems. But when I came home, I realized I was the one in trouble. As soon as I opened the door, Mom shoved her phone under my nose. What is this? My breath caught. There was a photo of me in a swimsuit on the screen. A photo from the shoot I had just returned from. But how? I mumbled something and Mom suddenly covered her face with her hands and began to cry. One of your classmates sent it to a group chat. One of the moms saw it and forwarded it to me. Baby, tell me the truth. Did someone get these photos and start blackmailing you? That's why you asked me for money, right? To calm her down, I had to tell my mom the whole truth about Anna, fake tutoring and the photo shoot. I was sure Mom would be happy. After all, nothing terrible had happened, but she suddenly got even angrier. I thought those photos were stolen from you, and you were beside yourself with worry, but you actually agreed to such madness of your own free will? God, how humiliating! My mom had never punished me as seriously as she did that day. She took away all my pocket money and changed our Wi-Fi password. She also hired a real physics tutor. Long story short, my life turned into hell, and I knew who was to blame. Whitney, of course. She had already bullied Anna for her photos, and now she decided to pick on me? Kevin must have turned out to be an acquaintance of hers. She had probably put him up to arranging that stupid photo shoot, and as soon as she got the scandalous photos, sent them to group chats. I couldn't leave it like that. The next morning, I found Whitney and pinned her to the wall. What the hell did you do that for? Fighting at school is one thing, but bringing our parents into this is going too far. Hey, back off. I don't know what you're talking about. Of course, I didn't believe her, but to take revenge then would have been madness. Mom would have punished me even harsher. I felt like everyone was discussing me the whole day. I wanted to talk to Anna about my problems, but for some reason she wasn't at school. Still, she wasn't even answering my messages or calls. I felt worried about my friend and went to her house after classes. Luckily, she was fine. As soon as Anna opened the door, I hugged her, but she suddenly pushed me away. I was shocked and demanded an explanation. You're a dumb, narcissistic doll. You don't really care about me. All this time, you've just been mocking me. Well, fine. Now you'll feel what it's like to be me. I'm the one who sent your photos to everyone. Didn't expect that, did you? Now get lost. I hate you. Tears ran down my face. Was that how Anna had decided to thank me for everything I had done for her? She turned me into a laughingstock. I turned around and hurried away from my ungrateful friend and suddenly ran into someone near her house. It was Kevin. What was he doing there? I slapped him. This is for lying to me and leaking my photos. The guy clearly hadn't been expecting such a turn. What are you on about? That's crazy. I haven't even downloaded your photos from the camera yet. Yeah, sure. Then what are you doing outside Anna's house? Here for your fee? Actually, I live here. He pointed to the house next door. Anna and I aren't exactly close. She invited me to her party once, but I never dared to approach her. I've liked her for a long time. That's when I understood everything. Kevin was the neighbor Anna was crazy about. It was so cute that I even smiled. But then I remembered how Anna had hurt me. I apologized to Kevin and went to the photo studio to finally sort everything out. I lied and said that I had lost my purse and asked to see the footage from the surveillance camera. I rewound it to the time of my photo shoot the day before. Kevin and I had been so caught up in the process that we hadn't even noticed Anna. She had hidden around the corner and filmed everything on her phone. Now it was clear to me why Anna was so furious with me. She was just jealous. It was so stupid. Kevin wasn't my type at all, and I would have never stolen my friend's boyfriend. But I still felt a little guilty. After all, I really had been flirting with him a little bit. The next day, I decided to bring them together and wrote two notes. One of them was Kevin inviting Anna to a date on the roof, and the other was Anna doing the same to him. A couple of hours before the date, I went up there myself, spread a blanket, prepared snacks and candles. After everything was ready, I decided to correct my other mistake and apologize to my mother. Oddly enough, she quickly forgave me, but she made me promise never to pose like that again. There was only one problem left. How was I supposed to survive at school after such a scandal? The next morning, I hesitantly walked into the classroom and, to my surprise, heard admiring whistles. It turned out that my classmates liked my bold photos, even Whitney. She said they looked like pictures from a real magazine. Long story short, I had been worried in vain. I had been teaching Anna to love herself, but forgot to follow my own advice. The same day after school, Anna came up to me. Kevin and I figured out that it was you who set up the date for us. Thank you, Julie. Just imagine, we're a couple now. And also, forgive me if you can. I blamed you for all of my problems. At first, I got stuck in the swimming ring because of you. Then you convinced me that I was beautiful and I posted photos on Instagram and embarrassed myself. But the most important thing that happened that day, I forgot my phone in the studio. I came to get it and I saw you and Kevin. And you look like that. I immediately imagined all sorts of things. I didn't promise Anna anything. After what she did, I realized you don't need to help everyone. Sometimes you can go too far even when you only wish the best for someone. Do you think I should forgive Anna?